Check your hatch hinges and emergency release handle. Sit there in position. Okay. Close them up. Check your safety pins in place. Give me some pressure on the hydraulic hand pump so I can set the parking brake. How long do I keep this up?
Well, you can't pump anymore.
Till the hydraulic gauge shows the pressure's up. That's okay now. Take a look outside.
If it hasn't been done within the previous hour, both props are turned over by hand, two or three revolutions, with the ignition off, just to clear out any oil that may have settled in the lower cylinder. Leave your inner side airphone off so we can hear each other.
Let's see. Next is the starting engines check.
Yeah, watch me.
Throttle 1/8 open. Cowl flaps open. Wing flap control up. Landing gear control down, lock on. Supercharger low, guard over controls. Oil shutters open. Carburetor air cold. Primers off until actually starting engine. Fuel booster off until ready to start engine. Nose gear emergency control normal, up. Main gear emergency control normal, up. Mixture idle cutoff. Propeller controls high RPM, forward. Selectors automatic, safety's on. Feathering normal to the rear. Battery switches both on. Master ignition switch on. That's the emergency bell button there. Main inverter switch on. Spare inverter off. Magneto switch on. I'm going to start the left engine first.
Clear. Clear.
Here's how we get them started, Jim. Starter energizing switch on for about 30 seconds. Booster pump on. Primer on for about 5 seconds. Then I press the engaging switch. Now it's your job to shove the mixture control to auto-rich the moment the engine fires.
Hits 40 degrees and the oil pressure drops suddenly to normal. The cylinder head temperature gauge will read from 100 to 200 degrees.
They're okay now. And you hit your emergency bell button again. That's a signal to the crew member back there to shut off the putt-putt and get out of the airplane.
We're ready to taxi out. It's the co-pilot's duty to handle radio conversation.
Tower from 7645 on south end of ramp, ready to taxi out for takeoff. Go ahead.
7645 from the tower. Clear to taxi to the north end of the north-south taxi strip and stand by for takeoff. Go ahead.
7645, roger.
Ready to go, Corporal?
Okay, sir.
Sign on the nose wheel when you inspected the well?
Yes, I did, Dick.
You'll notice it's easy to taxi the ship. There's no need for taxiing fat. In making a turn, always keep the inside gear rolling. Never bring it to a complete stop, as is often done in airplanes with conventional gear. And keep your eyes open on the ground or in the air. It isn't the airplane, it's what you hit with it. Make certain that your nose wheel is straight ahead. Otherwise, running up your separate engines, the airplane has a tendency to turn in the direction in which the nose wheel is cocked. The thrust from one of the engines might damage the nose wheel assembly. Corporal Smith is checking now to see if the nose wheel is straight. I get you, Captain. Next is the engine run up and prop check, one engine at a time. Push it up till it's doing 2,000 RPM. Different engines have slightly different manifold pressure reading. As soon as you see it drop, return the selector switch to increase RPM, and notice how the tachometer shows increase back to 2,000. Do you hear how the sound of the propeller changes? You can hardly miss it. That's right. Put your propeller selector switch in automatic, and test your propeller pitch control handle. Pull it partway back until the RPM decreases 200 revolutions, keeping your eye on the tachometer. Then push it forward, watching the tachometer to see that it returns to 2,000 RPM. The next step is to throttle back to 1,400 and do the same thing with the other engine. Now you run your engines up together to about 1,800. At the same time checking your manifold pressure against the RPM, be sure that both engines are putting out approximately the same power. Check the generators. If Corporal Smith finds the ammeters are showing more than 10 amps difference, we'll give this airplane back to the crew chief. Generators are okay. Oil temperature is 60 to 80. Oil pressure is 75 to 85.
Back.
Fuel pressure with booster pumps off, 15 to 17.
Check.
Turn the boosters on.
Yeah.
Should be 12 to 17 pounds now.
Check.
Is the takeoff checklist next?
Right.
Check instrument panel for placketed operations instructions. Cow flaps, open for all ground operation. Wing flaps, down 1/4 to 1/2 as required. Remove landing gear control lock. Supercharger low. Oil cooler shutters open except during extremely cold weather. Carburetor air control, hold. Hydraulic pressure, 750 to 950 pounds per square inch. Booster pumps on, primers off. Nose gear emergency control, normal up. Main gear emergency control, normal up. Mixture control, auto rich. Propeller controls, high RPM, forward. Propeller switches, selector, automatic. Safety on, feathering normal. Batteries on.
Are the generator mainline switches on, Corporal?
Generator's okay, sir.
Don't start takeoff with cylinder temperature above 205 degrees centigrade. Rudder and aileron tabs on zero. Elevator trim tab a few degrees tail heavy. Crew in position for takeoff.
Now you have definite duties during the takeoff. Watch the tachometer and see that it doesn't exceed 2600 RPM. Your right hand should be bare and ready to handle the propeller switches. Your left hand is used to raise the landing gear. Here's how you put your hand. By keeping your right hand down on the quadrant, you can keep the throttles from creeping back during takeoff. If your tachometer should show an increase above 2600, say 2880, put your propeller selector switch in fixed pitch position. Then hit your feather switch for about 2 seconds, being sure to return it to normal position. That's the procedure for correcting an overspeeding engine. The other emergency procedure to be prepared for is a decreasing RPM prop. Your props will be in automatic position, which is normal for takeoff. So if one of them shows a decrease RPM, put the selector switch in increased position and bring the RPM back to 2600. Then leave your selector switch in fixed pitch position. Understand?
Yeah.
Now, under no condition, retract the wheels until you get a definite signal from me. My hand will be on top of the throttles, and this will be it.
Roger.
Okay, call the tower.
Tower from 7645, north end and north-south taxi strip, ready to take off. Go ahead.
7645 from the tower, stand by. Ship landing, go ahead.
7645, Wilco.
Watch this ship coming in. Give you a chance to see a normal B-26 landing. Notice his nose drop. He's putting his flaps down now. As soon as they're down, he'll take his hydraulic pressure to be sure he has brakes. He establishes a glide of 140 miles per hour and holds it until he gets almost to the ground. And he flares and comes on in for a normal landing. See how he holds his nose wheel high and lets it down easy before he loses airspeed control. Then he applies his brakes gradually and turns off the runway. Get the idea?
I think so. Shall I call the tower?
Yeah.
Tower from 7645. Is it clear to take off? Go ahead.
7645 from the tower. You're clear to take off to the south on runway 14. Go ahead.
7645. Roger.
I'm going to take off with 44 inches manifold pressure and 2600 RPM. That's minimum. But if you need it, the manifold pressure can be pushed up to the red mark at 49 inches on this particular model. Boosters.
Air
speed indicator says we're picking up speed.
With the flaps up, the ship changes its attitude. You'll notice our nose has come up a bit and gains about 10 miles per hour. With the cowl flaps half closed and the oil cooler flaps half closed, it streamlines the airplane to the extent that it picks up about 5 miles per hour more. But you must not forget that these controls should be handled in accordance with cylinder head and oil temperature.
Really claws her way right up into those clouds, doesn't she?
Notice a pronounced shuddering just before the stall. before we do, I want to show you how this airplane flies on instruments. See how our gas is. Look at that B-26 moving in on us.
Yeah, we'll have to keep our eye on him.
Transfer gas to the main tanks. I'm going on instruments for a minute, and I want you to keep your eye on that B-26 from my side while I'm flying blind.
Yes, sir.
Hand me the blind flying hood.
little short of altitude, are we? I guess I'd better hit the emergency salvo release. I didn't expect to have to demonstrate these emergency procedures so soon.
Some speed on my dive, and I'll have to lose it by holding the nose up and letting the ship scoop.